नमस्ते, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर के चौधरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी, सब्जेक्ट एनिमल फिजियोलॉजी एंड एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ द मसल्स, एंड द फर्स्ट इज द स्लाइडिंग फिलामेंट मैकेनिज्म। When scientists examined the first electron micrograph of skeleton muscle, they were surprised to see that the length of the thick and the thin filaments were the same in both relaxed and contracted muscles. कि जो thin और thick filaments की length थी वो relaxed muscles के अंदर भी same और contracted muscles के भी अंदर भी। It had been thought that muscle contraction must be a folding process, somewhat like closing an accordion. Instead, researchers discovered that skeleton muscles short during contraction because thin and thick filaments slide past one another. The model describing this process is known as sliding filament mechanism. The muscle contraction occurs because myosin head attach to and walk along the thin filament at both end of a sarcomere, progressively pulling the thin filaments towards the M line. As a result, the thin filaments slide inward and meet at the center of a sarcomere. They may even move so far inward that their ends overlap. As the thin filaments slide inward, the Z disc come close together and the sarcomere short. However, the length of the individual thick and the thin filaments do not change. Shortening of sarcomere causes shortening of the whole muscle fiber, which in turn leads to shortening of the entire muscle. Now the contraction cycle. At the onset of contraction, the sarcoplasmic reticulum release calcium ions into the sarcoplasm. There they bind to troponin. Troponin then move tropomyosin away from the myosin binding site on the actin. You can see in that figure. Once the binding site are free, the contraction cycle and repeated sequence of events that cause the filament to slide begin. The contraction cycle consists of the four steps. You can see in the figure, and we start with the first step. First is the ATP hydrolysis. The myosin head include an ATP binding site and an ATPase, an enzyme that hydrolyzes ATP into the ADP and a phosphate group. This hydrolysis reaction reorient and energize the myosin head. Notice that product of ATP hydrolysis, ADP and a phosphate group are still attached to the myosin head. ये अभी भी myosin head के साथ attach रहेंगे. Second, attachment of myosin to actin to form cross bridge. तो there is, जब hydrolysis हुआ तो ATP का breakdown हुआ तो head के अंदर energy आ. The energized myosin head attached to the myosin binding site on the actin and release the previously hydrolyzed phosphate group. When myosin head attached to the actin during contraction, they are referred to as cross bridge. Third is the power stroke. After the cross bridge form, yani myosin attached to the actin, the power stroke occurs. During the power stroke, the site on the cross bridge where ADP is still bound open. As a result, cross bridge rotate and release the ADP. The cross bridge generate force as it rotate toward the center of the sarcomere, sliding the thick filament towards the M line. Then the fourth, detachment of myosin from actin. At the end of the power stroke, the cross bridge remain firmly attached to the actin until it bind another molecule of ATP. उसी के साथ अटैच रहेगा जब तक दूसरा ATP आकर के अटैच नहीं हो जाता. As the ATP bind to ATP binding site on the myosin head detaches from the actin. The contraction cycle repeat as the myosin ATPs hydrolyze the newly bound molecule of ATP and continue as long as ATP is available and the calcium ion level near the thin filament is sufficiently high. The cross bridges keep rotating back and forth with each power stroke, pulling the thin filament towards the M line. Each of the 600 cross bridges in one thick filament attach and detach about 5 times per second. At any one instant, some of the myosin head are attached to the actin, forming cross bridge and generating force, and other myosin heads are detached from actin, getting ready to bind again. सारे myosin head हैं वो एक साथ bind नहीं होते, simultaneously कुछ bind होते रहते हैं, कुछ detach होते रहते हैं, और contraction process चलता रहता है. As the contraction cycle continue, movement of cross bridge apply the force that draw the Z-disc toward each other and the sarcomere shorten. During a maximal growth, muscle contraction, the distance between two Z-disc can decrease to half the resting length. The Z-disc in turn pull on neighboring sarcomere and the whole muscle fiber shorten. Some of the component of the muscle are elastic, they stretch slightly before they transfer the tension generated by sliding filament. The elastic component include titin molecule, connective tissue around the muscle fiber and tendons that attach the muscles to the bone. In some contraction, the cross bridge rotate and generate tension, but the thin filament cannot slide inward because the tension they generate is not large enough to move the load on the muscles, such as trying to lift a whole box of books with one hand. This is about all about the sliding filament theory of muscle contraction. This session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you. Thank you very much.